In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Juanita was buried with Christ, crucified with him, and rose to new life with him. May she now come to rest in his eternal glory. Amen.
Please join in our opening song, Be Not Afraid, number 431. You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the face of God and live. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest. Pass through raging waters in the sea, you shall not drown. If you walk amid the burning flames, you shall not be harmed. If you stand before the power of hell, and death is at your side,
as we gather together to bid farewell to this woman who was to us a mother, a grandmother, an aunt, and to almost all, Tia Jane. We pray for her eternal rest, grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. Amen. Let's begin this Mass in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship with the Holy Spirit be with all of you. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Juanita Vasquez, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Book of Lamentations. It is good to wait in silence for the Lord God to save. My soul is deprived of peace. I have forgotten what happiness is. I tell myself my future is lost, all that I hope for from the Lord. The thought of my homeless poverty is wormwood and gall. Remembering it over and over leaves my soul downcast within me. But I will call this to mind as my reason to have hope. The favors of the Lord are not exhausted. His mercies are not spent. They are renewed each morning. So great is his faithfulness. My portion is the Lord, says my soul. Therefore, I will hope in him. Good is the Lord to one who waits for him, to the soul that seeks him. It is good to hope in silence for the saving help of the Lord, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our song response is Psalm 23, Shepherd Me, O God, number 457.
A reading from the second letter of Paul to the Corinthians. We know that if our earthly dwelling, a tent, should be destroyed, we have a building from God, a dwelling not made with hands, eternal in heaven. So we are always courageous, although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. For we walk by faith and not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please him, whether we are at home or away. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each one may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord.
Spirit and life, you have the words of everlasting life. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up on the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. There are moments when we gather together at this point in a person's life as they make this transition from this life to the next, that sometimes there's some trepidation. And then there are other times, like this time, when there's great confidence and joy, because we see the beauty of a life lived well, a long and fruitful life, that bore fruit in so many different ways in her life. And now, not dying, just moving on, changing her address from this earth to heaven. When Jesus spoke these words of the Beatitudes, "Blessed are those who mourn, blessed are those who hunger, blessed are the poor in spirit, blessed are the pure in heart, blessed are the peacemakers." When Jesus spoke those words, he was speaking, first of all, about himself. Jesus was the one who mourned over Jerusalem and said, "Oh, how I wish I could have gathered you together as a hen gathers her chicks, but you would not." He is the one who made peace between mankind and God. He was the pure in heart who could see God. He was the one that hungered after righteousness, filled with righteousness himself, the man of righteousness, but also the one who sought righteousness in others, that we might enjoy that presence of God that he did. So he spoke these words first of himself, but then for all who follow after him, who live his life, who allow themselves to be transformed by his very presence, who have suffered with him, shared his crucifixion and baptism, as we mentioned in the back, and risen with him to new life, the new life that we live here now first, and then eventually live with him in glory forever. Tia Jane. What an amazing woman. I didn't get to meet her. I haven't been here at this parish very long. But I've heard the stories about her. I've heard who she is and what kind of a woman she was. And I reflect on her life, who as a child was a migrant farm worker who followed the crops and worked hard in the fields. I remember myself when I was in seminary, right? I was studying seminary, and it was in the Pacific Northwest. And at the time, there was a lot of discussion about the plight of migrant workers. Some of you may remember that if you're old enough. Cesar Chavez, you know, was raising up a awareness of the plight of migrant workers. And I was a seminarian, all right? And I thought, I should learn about this. So actually, I went and spent the day working alongside migrant workers in the field, picking strawberries, actually, because that was a major crop in the Pacific Northwest. I worked all day long in the heat of the sun, and I made $4. And I just had a tremendous respect for those who eked out a living that way. And I saw families with 8, 10, 12 kids. They're all out in the field together, working together as a family, working together as a unit, so they could pull together enough money really simply for survival. And I thought, you know, I really am much better off than they are, at least monetarily. You know, I have a home, and you know, I have some income. But I thought, what treasure they have to be able to work together as a family, to pitch in, and the kids never complained. They're out there working side by side. And when I learned that Tia Jane had done that as a child, I just remember, I picture these families out there in the fields, how hard life was for them. But yet there was also a joy and a hope, and certainly a love. Of course, she was able to get some schooling. I understand she made it through the fifth grade. But her knowledge was much deeper than what she gained from her teachers, because she was taught by God. Today happens to be the feast of St. John Vianney, who some of you may or may not know who he was, but he was a man who was born from peasants, not unlike Tia Jane. He wanted to be a priest, but quite frankly, the seminary said he was too stupid to be a priest. He couldn't learn Latin. So a bishop took pity on him and gave him some little country parish out in the middle of nowhere, and he never learned Latin. But he learned from God. And he taught about God with such simplicity that people came from miles around to hear him speak. And now he's the patron saint of priests. Tia Jane, who learned from God and from her family, the faith that was imparted to her by this family who worked in the fields as she was a child, she received that faith and she passed that down to her own children and grandchildren. And I understand in the late 60s, her and her husband moved into this area. They became members of Guardian Angels. And I hear the story. She was in the altar society. She was always there working the ice cream socials that eventually developed into this big festival that we typically have in June, but not this year because of the pandemic. She was always serving the church. And I understand she was the baker of the family. Is that right? Who's going to start baking the cakes now for the family? Oh, okay. So we have the next baker right here, baking the cakes for birthdays and special occasions, giving not just of her time and her efforts, giving of her life and imparting her faith to those who would come after her. This little girl who worked in the fields, who grew up to bear such fruit as we have here in her family and in her friends, just to demonstrate that what matters in life really isn't how much money you have in your bank account or how much education you got or what kind of benefits that were handed to you. But what matters is the principles of faith, family, and hard work. That's Tia Jane. And of course, you know now, you know what happens when saints go to heaven? They pray for us, right? That's why we're always asking the saints to pray for us. And she's praying for us right now. And you know what she's praying? She's praying this. May my friends and my family, my children and my grandchildren, may they impart to their children the principles of faith, family, and hard work. There are principles that are too easy for us to lose in our modern society with all of its distractions, with all of its temptations. But those are the principles that make us strong. They are the principles that give us joy. Those are the principles that fill our lives with meaning and purpose. Faith, family, and hard work. So we gather to celebrate the life of this woman who lived a full life, who rose up from extreme poverty into a life that was filled with her faith, with her family. And it was hard work that helped get her there. We celebrate her life. We rejoice that she is with Jesus forever. And let us never forget that she is there in Jesus' face every single day, praying for each of us who are here this morning. May they impart to their children and to their children's children the principles by which I lived my life of faith, family, and hard work. And may we, all of whom she considered to be her grandchildren, she was everybody's grandma, right? She was everybody's grandma. And she is here praying today. Joining our prayers and praises into one, let us now present our needs and petitions to the Lord.
That the bishops and the priests of the church and all who preach the gospel may be given the strength to express in action the word they proclaim, we pray to the Lord. Our sister Juanita was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Pray to the Lord. The family and friends of Juanita seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and the doubt that come from grief. We pray to the Lord. That those who bear the cross of pain in mind or body may never feel forsaken by God. We pray to the Lord. That God may be a place in the kingdom of heaven to all the faithful departed. We pray to the Lord.
Heavenly Father, hear and answer our prayers according to your will as we put our trust in you. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Please join in our song for the preparation of gifts. Here I am, Lord, number 373.
People in my heart.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you, O Lord, these sacrificial offerings for the salvation of your servant Juanita, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of all the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Indeed, are holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for our unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and James, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you in your compassion, O merciful Father. Gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, and remember your servant Juanita, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth you will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours forever and ever. And now, at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom, the power, and the glory, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. And mindful of appropriate social distance, let us offer one another the sign of peace.
Thank you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy.
Behold, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. In receiving communion, in this day and age, we ask you to wear your masks while in the aisle, come forth to receive communion in your hand, and then you may step up to either side to pull down your mask and receive and return to your seats.
Here I first meet.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our sister Juanita may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. May our prayers rise before you as incense, O Lord, lifting up of our hands as the evening sacrifice. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express the affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Juanita, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessing which you bestowed upon her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this to Christ our Lord. Amen. And now in peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest. The Lord be with you. What are we doing? Oh, I forget this so many times. There's a mark of remembrance. You may be seated, and please forgive me. I've done this before.
On behalf of my entire family, I would like to begin by thanking everyone for gathering here today in celebration. We have received countless texts, calls, mails, visits, thoughts, and prayers. Each act of kindness has been comforting during this difficult time and a true reminder of the impact my Grandma Jane had on others. Grandma Jane lived such a beautiful life filled with countless memories. If you had the chance to sit and chat with her, then you must have heard all about her time on the beet field in Minnesota, alongside her parents and 8 siblings. I wish I could drink a coffee with her and hear those stories one more time. She loved her family unconditionally, every sister and brother. Grandma Jane showed us that when we have each other, we have everything. She laid the foundation, and today, because of her influence, we are a strong, loving family. Grandma met Grandpa Tony after she and her family decided to make the move from the beet fields to Kansas City. 2 people with distant personalities fell deeply in love. They vowed to love each other through sickness and in health and until death take them to their eternal home. They stuck to that promise, and nothing brings me greater joy than knowing that they're reunited yet again. 2 people so different yet so in love brought a beautiful baby girl into the world together. Christine, or as many as you know her, Chops. And there, that's where the legacy began. While they are both physically gone, they are far from forgotten. My family and I will forever treasure the many memories we shared in their home and are so thankful to have two guardian angels watching over us all. Her grandkids, Janice, Katrina, Jenny, and Christy, have always admired the warm and loving atmosphere she created in her home during holidays, birthdays, and family gatherings. They especially loved her one-of-a-kind back rubs. Grandma Jane was always welcoming to anyone who walked through her front door, and she would always make sure that you left with a full stomach. One of her favorite things to do was to get down to the kitchen. Every meal and every dessert she made was created with love. From character birthday cakes to wedding cakes, she did it all. My all-time favorite dish is her mole. Every time we had her mole, she would always tell us how she learned from the best, her mother. I cannot wait to continue with her tradition and pass down that delicious recipe to the future kids who will be riding their bikes down the sidewalks or playing volleyball in the front yard. My favorite memory with Grandma is when she took Angel and me to Our Lady of Snow Shrine in Illinois. I will never forget the church's beautiful architecture. She's the one who introduced me to my faith, and because of her, I continue to trust in God's plan. I wish I could stand here and talk about all the memories we have shared with her, but we would be here for days. So with that being said, thank you, Grandma. Thank you for shaping us. Thank you for your guidance and your strength. But most importantly, thank you for sharing your beautiful life with us. Because of you, we know the importance of family, and we would not be who we are today without you. We love you, and you are forever in our hearts.
And now the Lord be with you. May God Almighty bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God. Please join in our closing song on Eagle's Wings, number 436. We'll begin with the refrain.
Thousands fall about you. Hear you, it shall.
like the sun. At home you hid the pond. What is that? For to his angels he's given a command to guard you in all of your ways. Upon their hands they will bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn. Oh.